when the H.W. Bush administration mooted the Africa Growth and Opportunities Act, AGOA, over a decade ago, there was much optimism that the trade gulf that existed between the African continent and the United States would be significantly reduced. This, however, is yet to be, as many African countries, even under the original blocs such as COMESA, continue to struggle to meet the free access market quota to the US market for particular products.
As you know, the American footwear market is estimated at around $80 billion. And the COMESA region is only contributing 0.003. And the constraints which the enterprises are facing are many, but most of them are because they don't know how to approach a global market. Because the global market is dynamic, it's fashion oriented. The product that you sell this month, you may not sell it next month.
And with wanting leather-related trading and production capacity being blamed as the main driver of such a lackluster performance for the region, experts from the Leather and Leather Products Institute have embarked on helping to build local capacity in the subsector.
Today, 4.5 years down the line, we are looking at products which you have seen yourself, which are marketable to any regional market. The only dilemma we have now is to bring them to the globalization that we are now trying to fast track so that they could enjoy some of the benefits that are there.
While the country lags behind players such as Ethiopia, good milestones have so far been attained.
A leather policy, we now have one. We didn't have a strategy, we have one. We unbundled the strategy, and each person, each stakeholder was given what they had to do.
Currently, Uganda, through COMESA LLPI, is building a country-based leather industry design studio, which will be open to all players in the leather industry who would want to further skills in producing leather products. Malcolm Sime, NTV Tonight, Business.